Hello friends, welcome to Wow IS. This is the 12th edition of the April 2023 current affairs. In this, we are going to cover the culture aspect. In this initiative, we are going to cover Vision Monthly magazine from April 2023 to February 2024 in a very brief manner, that is hardly one third of the actual length of the Vision magazine. And this is available only at 599 rupees. So you can enroll in this initiative through this QR code. And you can send the payment slip at wowindiais@gmail.com. Now let's move to the first article for the day. First one is culture. Indian knowledge system in higher education. Now UGC University Grants Commission has released some draft guidelines for the incorporation of the Indian knowledge system in the higher education for undergraduate and postgraduate courses. Earlier in 2020, IKS Division of Ministry of Education was set up to promote research and disseminate Indian knowledge system. Also, expertise in the Indian knowledge system has been added recently in the final version of the National Credit Framework. So this is the update. Next is Indian Traditional Knowledge System or Bharati Gyan Parampara Division. This is under Ministry of Education and it was established as an innovative cell under Ministry of Education at AICTE in 2020. Its vision was to promote interdisciplinary research on all aspects of Indian knowledge system, preserve and disseminate Indian knowledge system for further research and societal application. The functions are very simple one, for example, facilitate and coordinate IS related, IKS related inter and interdisciplinary work done by various institutions in India and abroad, including R&D and laboratories. Next, establish, guide and monitor subject-wise interdisciplinary research group for institute centers. Thirdly, create, promote, popularize schemes and facilitate funding of projects and develop mechanisms to undertake research. Also, to make policy recommendations. What are the key features of the guidelines that have been released? First of all, credit course in IKS. At least 5% of the marks of the total mandated credits will be given to the IKS or Indian Knowledge System. At least 15% of the credit appropriated for the IKS should be related to major discipline. Okay. Next, emphasis on authentic sources. So it will be based on authentic sources such as source text, historical accounts or inscriptions. Thirdly, focus on continuity. Indian knowledge tradition from ancient time up to relatively recent period in the design of the course content. Then next is medium of instruction would be any Indian language apart from Sanskrit and English. Any Indian language of all the languages mentioned in the Schedule 8 of our constitution or any other language, that medium will be used for imparting IKS knowledge to the students. Then transition from Sanskrit, then technical terms and citations from the Sanskrit sources should be given in the Devanagari script as well as in English transliteration. Then what is the significance? Significance is nurturing the rich legacy of India. As you know, Nalanda and Takshila, they are even more ancient universities than your Oxford or Cambridge. Then decolonizing Indian education system, because we are now trying to dwell into our own knowledge system. Thirdly, application of IKS in current times, knowledge of Ayurveda, construction of ships in ancient times, aircrafts, knowledge, architecture of Indus Valley civilization, political science, etc. These things can be used in today. They can be applied in today's world as well. Next is bring closer to cultural ethos. Exposure to the controversial and contemporary concepts like bring engineers closer to their cultural ethos, expand their intellectual horizons and enhance their confidence. Next is challenges in integration of IKS. Employability factor is the first one. Then willingness of students, shortage of trained faculty and may increase burden of additional courses on the student. So these are the challenges. Next is national mission for cultural mapping. Government has identified and documented distinctive features of more than 1 lakh villages under Mera Gaon, Meri Dharohar, My Village, My Heritage program of the National Mission for Cultural Mapping. Now some examples which have been mentioned are, first is Sinauli in Uttar Pradesh. Sinauli in Uttar Pradesh, it is a Harappan site. Here it is a Bronze Age civilization where solid disc wheel carts found in 2018 and has been interpreted as chariots. Then Reni in Uttarakhand, it is famous for Chipko movement of 1974. Then Suketi Fossil Park of Himachal Pradesh, it is also called Shivalik Fossil Park. It has a collection of more than 2.5 million years old vertebrate fossils. And it also displays life-size fiberglass models of six of the prehistoric animals that lived in the era from 1 to 1.5 million years ago. Then Pandersan, Jammu and Kashmir, it is a 14th century Kashmiri saint and mystic point Lal Deg, also known as Lala or Laleshwari. His writings are also called Vaks. So they are there. Then Bisnoi of Rajasthan, it is a case study for living in harmony with nature. Villages follow a set of 29 Bis and Noi principles, which include norms related to protection of animals and conservation of trees. Now, something about Mera Gaon, Meri Dharovar survey. The objective is to document the cultural identity of at the village level by involving citizens to share what makes their village, block, district unique. It aims to harness the unique cultural heritage of rural India. Mechanism. It involves common service centers, village level entrepreneurs conducting meetings with locals and then uploading interesting facts about their villages on to an application. It can be places of interest, customs and traditions, famous personalities, festivals and beliefs, art and culture, etc. of the villages. Then Coordination Ministry of Culture has partnered with the CSC under Ministry of Electronics and IT. So Ministry of Culture and Ministry of Electronics and IT. They are both involved here. Then about National Mission for Cultural Mapping. It was initiated by Ministry of Culture in 2017. The goals are to preserve the threads of rich Indian art and cultural heritage, converting vast and widespread cultural canvas of India into objective cultural mapping, then design a mechanism to fulfill the aspirations of the artist community and creating strong cultural vibrancy throughout the nation. Institutions involved are CSC E-Governance Service India Limited, is given task by Ministry of Culture to carry out the NMCM. Then mission is being executed under the guidance of Indira Gandhi National Center of Arts, ICNCA. At the broad level, there are three important objectives of the mission that are National Cultural Awareness Abhiyan, Hamari Sanskriti, Hamari Pehchan Abhiyan, Our Culture, Our Identity. It is conducted from block to national level by arranging awareness program at the local about cultural heritage. Next, National Artist Talent Hunt or Scouting Program or Sanskrit Pratibha Yojana Khoj Abhiyan. So for the hidden talent, this scheme is for the hidden talent. Next is National Cultural Workplace NCWP. It is fully equipped cultural portal which will serve as common interaction workplace for all stakeholders including artists, institutions, NGOs and Ministry of Culture. Now something about Indira Gandhi National Center for Arts. So it is under Ministry of Culture, established in 1987 as autonomous institution. The mandate is to act as a center for research, academic pursuit and dissemination in the field of arts. Clear? Keep it clear. It has six functional units: Kalanidhi Multiform Library, Kalakosh devoted to the study and publication of fundamental texts in Indian languages, Janpad Sampada engaged in lifestyle studies, then Kaladarshan transforms research and studies into visible forms through exhibitions, then cultural informatics, applied technology tools for cultural preservation and propagation, Sutradhar administrative section that acts as a spine supporting coordinating for all activities. Then Raja Ravi Verma, he was the earliest proponent of lithography in India. What is lithography? It is art of producing a work on flat stone or metal plate. He was one of the few painters who managed to accompany a beautiful union of Indian tradition with the techniques of European academic art. He was also responsible in taking Indian art all over the world with his impeccable technique. He was notable for making affordable copies of his paintings available to the public. Then fact sheet. Also known as the father of modern Indian art, he is best known for his paintings and prints that exquisitely render Indian subjects using European techniques. Date of birth, April 29, 1848. Date of place of birth is Kilimanur Tervankur. Place of death, October 2, 1906. Profession, painter artist. Classification of paintings, portraits, portrait based compositions, theoretical compositions based on myths and legends. Teacher, Ram Swami Naidu and Theodor Jensen, a Dutch painter. Awards, Kesare Hind Gold Medal 1904. Government of Kerala has instituted an award in his name. Then next is News in Shorts. Global Buddhist Summit 2023, it concluded with Delhi, New Delhi Declaration, and was organized by Ministry of Culture. Key highlights of the New Delhi Declaration are: in the present world scenario, texts, doctrines and philosophy of the Buddha Dharma are the best guide for interfaith dialogue, harmony and universal peace. Recognize significance of Buddhist pilgrimage as a living heritage. Thirdly, summit highlighted the role of Buddhism in India's soft power strategy. And you know soft power? Soft power is enabling a change in behavior in others without competition or conflict by using persuasion and attraction. Now, Sanchi is situated in Madhya Pradesh. It has become the country's first solar city. And as you know, Buddhist monuments at Sanchi are given UNESCO World Heritage Site status. Then Manna Madurai Pottery. This is pottery of Shivgangai district of Tamil Nadu, got geographical indicator tag. A unique type of clay is sourced from water bodies like Nendukulan, Nathapurakki, Sundara Nadappu, then Sekailathur to make these pots. Main raw material for these pots are soil and water. Then Vagai river, which runs through the Manna Madurai village, enriches the clay used in the pottery. So you need to remember the name of the river, the name of the place and the name of the pottery. It has got GI tag. Then Ladakh wood cravings. It is uploaded the GI tag for Ladakh's wood craving, a first of its kind. Wood craving of Ladakh has been an aesthetically vibrant art form in Ladakh region. The Nagri Dubraj rice. Chhattisgarh's Nagri Dubraj rice variety has got GI tag. After Jeerapul rice in 2019, Dubraj is the second brand to get GI tag. Then women self-help group Ma Durga Swasth Samuh of Nagri Dhamtari district has been harvesting Dubraj rice and which has applied for the GI tag. The Nagri Dubraj is also known as Basmati of Chhattisgarh because of its fragrance. The grain finds reference in Valmiki Ramayana. The rice is rich in indigenous variety and small grains. Then have Pushkar or Pushkaram festival. Pushkaralu or Pushkaram festival. It is a 12-day festival of Telugu speaking people commenced in Varanasi. So keep it, try to remember it. It is a festival of Telugu speaking people and it commenced in Varanasi. That is going to confuse you. The Pushkaralu refers to worship of the 12 sacred rivers in which the god Pushkar appears every 12 years. Rivers are Ganga, Yamuna, Godavari, Krishna, Kaveri, Bhima, Tapti, Narmada, Saraswati, Tungabhadra, Sindhu and Pranhita. The celebration happens annually once in 12 years along each river which are associated with zodiac sign. Then Haki Piki, it is predominantly living in Shivamoga, Davangiri and Mysuru district of Karnataka. They are also known for knowledge of traditional and herbal medicine that are in high demand in African countries. Haki Pikis are said to be matriarchal group. They speak an Indo-Aryan language and communicate Wagri, mother tongue, at home but speak in Kannada when conducting daily business. UNESCO has listed Wagri as one of the endangered languages. You need to remember this. It is important. The next is Abhilekh Patal. PM praised the Abhilekh Patal portal. It is a portal with over 1 crore pages of historical records of National Archives. It is full-featured web portal to access National Archives of the India NAI, reference media and its digitalized collections through internet. It is an initiative of NAI to make it Indian archival records available to all. So with this we conclude our culture aspect for the day and we shall meet with the last part of this video tomorrow. So thank you very much and keep studying. Good luck to everyone.